was day two. Right now, me and Ronnie are on our way to the Holocaust Museum.
Berman Jewish Studies and Holocaust Center.
So, thought we'd check that out and see what it is. Should be fun.
This is the William Berman Jewish Heritage Museum in Atlanta, Georgia. Look at the Holocaust Gallery.
You said you did a report on that? Or you spoke about it in class?
A long time.
Trying to figure out if this is mocking the Jewish people. What were you saying?
By their facial expressions, it's total stereotypical European Jew persona. That's not the word I'm looking for, but the fact that they all have the hair, the top hats, the long snouts, and pigs are greedy animals. So it's a total like.
Look at this poster. I think this is pretty interesting. Eradication of the sick and weak in nature. So obviously they're comparing to the Jews. Germany in 1932. As you can see in this room, there are a lot to look at, a lot of pictures, stories talking about Jewish heritage, what happened. I'm not going to be able to get everything individually, but I just would like to get a quick view of what I'm looking at here. It's the picture of a German children reading an anti-Semitic school book called The Poison Mushroom. There's a couple pages from the book. This one says, just that it is often difficult to tell poisonous from inedible mushrooms, it is often difficult to recognize Jews as thieves and criminals. This one, page 9. It says the Jew nose is crooked at the top. It looks like the number 6. This was like one of their methods of determining if somebody was a Jew. This one as well. It's an eye color comparison. Much stuff to really look at and read. Just a quick to show you how much there is.
was a Christian woman who had to wear a sign around her neck for shopping at a Jewish store. So it was their public humiliation. They made the Jews shovel dirt. They say as a menial task so the public can look at them and humiliate them. Look at this. An actual hole in the building to show this picture. Children help each other through a hole in the ghetto wall. Warsaw ghetto. Small children sometimes sneak at the risk of their lives through a small opening to look for food outside the ghetto and smuggle it in. Lots of history to look at. Picture of the deportation of the Jews. This picture Ronnie's taking a picture of. Children just prior to the execution. Isn't that sad? As Ronnie pointed out, the execution by is killed at close range. So can you just imagine that happening to those group of children? Picture of a group of children in Auschwitz, burnt victims from an experiment. Here's the experiment. It's to determine how long a body can withstand underwater, under freezing water. Here's a description of the picture on the ceiling I showed earlier. Right under it is, this is where Anne Frank was hiding in Amsterdam. Here's a page from her diary, basically with a picture saying, hopefully she can make it in Hollywood one day. Here's the bookcase that led to the staircase where they were hiding. Here's a map. A little hard to see with the glare, but it shows where she was born in Frankfurt, and then where she left to go into hiding. You can see it goes up to Amsterdam, and then when they were caught in Amsterdam, brought to Westerbrook, all the way down to Auschwitz, where her parents were killed, and she was brought up back to Bergen. Bergen's kind of hid behind the glare of